Dear students, in the previous class we discussed about the some of the aspects which is related to the electron transport system, and also we discussed about the different complexes which are present in electron transport system. Before understanding the electron transport system in detail, we need to understand the electron carriers which are plays a very important role in the electron transport system. There are many electron carriers are there, all those are going to be involved in the electron transport system, and today we are going to discuss about that one. So here, as we discussed in the previous class, all the catabolic reactions are ultimately provide the energy to the cells in the form of the production of the ATP inside the cells. So here, in all those catabolic reactions, generally called as the enzymes called as the dehydrogenases. Those dehydrogenases, they are going to extract the electron from the catabolic reactions and donate those electrons to the universal electron carriers called as the NAD or the FAD. And these NAD and the FAD, they are going to capture the electrons from these enzymes and ultimately reduces. And these electron carriers ultimately donate the electrons to the electron transport system. So that's why we need to understand regarding the electron carriers. So here first we need to discuss about the one of the electron carrier called as the NAD. So here this NAD, we need to look into the structure of the NAD first. So here the NAD, it is nothing but the abbreviation of the nicotine amide adenine dinucleotide. Why it is called as the nicotine amide adenine dinucleotide? So here if you look into the structure of the NAD, so it will be having the nicotine amide. So here this is the structure of the nicotine amide. So here this nicotine amide, it is derived from the vitamin called as the niacin, and this nicotine amide, it will be attached to the ribose sugar, and in turn this ribose sugar attached to the phosphate group. And here in this case, this nicotine amide, it is going to act as the base, and it will be attached to the sugar, and in turn this sugar, it is attached to the phosphate group. So here entire this structure, it is going to act as a nucleotide, because a nucleotide, it will be having the nitrogenous base and the sugar and the phosphate group, and here also it is the same case. So here entire this structure, it is going to form the nucleotide, and here this nucleotide, it is attached to the one more nucleotide, where the other nucleotide, it will be having the adenine, and in turn the adenine, it is attached to the ribose sugar, and in turn the ribose sugar, it is attached to the phosphate group. So here enter this structure, it is going to form the other nucleotide. So here these two nucleotides are going to be linked with one another with the help of the phosphoanhydride bond. So it is nothing but the phosphoanhydride bond. These two nucleotides are linked to one another with the help of the phosphoanhydride bond. So here the entire this structure, it is going to called as the NAD. It is nothing but the nicotine amide adenine dinucleotide. Why it is called as the dinucleotide means, it will be hanged to the two nucleotides are attached. So here this is the one nucleotide, and it is the other nucleotides. Both of these two nucleotides are attached with the help of the phosphoanhydride bond and form the dinucleotide. It is called as the nicotine amide adenine dinucleotide. So here along with the NAD, one more closely related structure is there. It is called as the NADP. So here in this case NADP, if a phosphate group is attached to this ribose sugar, it is going to form the nicotine amide adenine dinucleotide phosphate. So here the difference between the NAD and the NADP, it is just the difference of the phosphate group. So here very importantly, the NAD, it is going to be plays a very important role in the catabolic reactions, whereas the NADP, it plays a very important role in the anabolic reactions. Since we are discussing about the electron transport system, which is a very important crucial part of the catabolic reaction, so here we need to concentrate on the NAD rather than the NADP. So here some of the enzymes which are involved in the catabolic reactions, they will be having the NAD as the coenzyme. Okay. So here those enzymes, so they are going to extract the two electrons and two protons. Two electrons and the two protons from the substrate, and here out of which the two electrons and the one proton, it is transferred to the NAD plus, and this NAD plus, it is reduces into the NADH, whereas the remaining one proton, it is released into the media. and it is going to result into the oxidation of the substrate. So here, that is how these enzymes, they play a very important role. So here what they will do, these enzymes which are having the NAD as the coenzyme, they are going to extract the two electrons and the two protons from the substrate, and out of which the two electrons and the one proton in the form of the, we are going to call it as the hydride ion. Hydride ion refers to a proton which is having the two electrons. So here this hydride ion, it is transferred to the NAD plus and it is completely reduced into the NADH, whereas the remaining one proton, it is released into the media. So here if you look into the structure of the NAD plus, so here where those two electrons are accepted. So here those two electrons and the protons are accepted to the nicotinamide part of the NAD plus. So here the two electrons and the one proton, it is accepted to the nicotinamide and it is completely reduces into the NADH. So here the remaining one proton, it is released into the media. So here in this case, what we need to understand or remember is nothing but the NAD plus, it can accept two electrons and the one proton from the reaction, from the enzymatic reaction which is mediated by the dehydrogenases. So here from the enzymatic reaction, the NAD plus, it is going to take up two protons and the one two electrons and the one proton and completely reduce into the NADH, whereas the remaining one proton, it is released into the media. That we need to remember. So here the electrons are accepted on the by the nicotinamide part of the NAD plus. So here the NAD plus, why it is called as a plus, it is because of the presence of the a positive charge on the nitrogen atom of the nicotinamide. So here after accepting the two electrons and the one proton, so here this the nicotinamide, it is going to convert it itself into the benzenoid form into the quinonoid form. So here this ring, it is present in the benzenoid form, but here after accepting the two electrons and the one proton, it will be converted into the quinonoid form. So here this is the quinonoid form. That we need to remember. So here from these things, we need to remember the one thing, very important role. So here some of the enzymes which are involved in the catabolic reactions, they will be having the NAD plus as the coenzyme. Okay, from those enzymatic reactions, so here the two electrons and the two protons are extracted, and out of which the two electrons and the one proton, it is donated to the NAD plus, and NAD plus will be reduced into the NADH. Okay, the remaining one proton will be released into the media. That we need to remember. So we need to remember NAD plus, maximally it can accept two electrons and the one proton and reduces completely into the NADH. That we need to remember. Okay, and similarly, the second universal electron carrier, which is plays a very important role in the electron transport system, which is nothing but the FAD, which is called as the flavin adenine dinucleotide. So here also some of the enzymes which are involved in the different catabolic reactions, they'll be having the FAD or the FMN as the coenzymes or the cofactors. So here before understanding the enzymatic reactions and everything, let us look into the structure of the FAD. So here this FAD, so here in this case, if you look at the structure of the FAD in this case, it will be having the isoalloxazin ring. So here this is the isoalloxazin ring. This isoalloxazin ring, it is derived from the vitamin called as the riboflavin. It is derived from the vitamin called as the riboflavin. This isoalloxazin ring, it is attached to the ribitol sugar. This is the ribitol sugar or the ribitol moiety, I can call. So here this ribitol sugar, in turn it is attached to the phosphate group. This is the phosphate group, and collectively it is going to form the nucleotide, because this isoalloxazin ring, it acts as the base, and in turn it is formed with the covalent bond with the ribitol sugar, and in turn it is attached to the phosphate group. Entire this structure, it is going to act as the nucleotide. It is called as the flavin mononucleotide. So it is the one type of the electron carrier. Some of the enzymes, they will be having the FMN or the flavin mononucleotide as the cofactor. Okay, what about the FAD? In case of the FAD, the second nucleotide, it is also going to attach to the FMN and going to form the FAD. So here it is the adenine sugar, adenine moiety, and it is attached to the ribose sugar, and in turn it is attached to the phosphate group. So enter this structure, it is going to form the nucleotide. This nucleotide attaches to the FMN and going to form the dinucleotide. And here these two nucleotides are attached to one another with the help of the, as I already told you in case of the NAD, with the help of the phosphoanhydride bond, which is nothing but the phosphoanhydride bond. Both these two nucleotides are attached to one another, linked with, you know, with the help of their phosphate groups, with the help of the phosphoanhydride bond. Entire this structure, it is called as the FAD. Okay, only the isoalloxazine ring, ribitol moiety and the phosphate groups comprise the FMN. And if this FMN attaches to the second nucleotide, second adenine nucleotide, and enter this structure forms the FAD. Okay, so here some of the enzymes which are involved in the catabolic reactions, they will be associated with the these flavin nucleotides. So here the FMN and the FAD, both of them are called as the flavin nucleotides. Both of them are called as the flavin nucleotides. Okay, so here some of these enzymes which are involved in the catabolic reactions, they will be having the either the FMN or the FAD as the coenzymes. And these enzymes, they are going to extract the electrons from the substrate, and they are going to donate the electrons to these electron carriers, or the these universal electron carriers. And these universal electron carriers, ultimately they are going to donate the electrons to the electron transport system and ultimately contribute for the ATP generation. And here we need to remember in this case is how the electrons are accepted. So here this isoalloxazine ring, it is the moiety which is going to accept the electrons. So here if it is accept the, so here if it is accept the one proton and the one electron from the substrate, it is going to be halfly reduced into the semiquinone radical. Okay. And here if it is accept the second electron and the second proton, and it is completely reduced into the FADH2. So here that means the FAD or the FMN, so here the maximally it can accept the two electrons and the two protons from the substrate and completely reduce into the FADH2 or the FMNH2. So here from the enzymatic reactions, so here the enzyme, it is going to extract two electrons, two protons from the substrate, donate those two electrons and those two protons to the FAD or the FMN, and here in this case it is the first electron, the first proton, it is transferred, and in this case it is the second electron, the second proton, it is transferred, and it is completely reduced into the FMNH2 or the FADH2. Okay, so here we need to remember one thing very importantly in this case is nothing but the FAD or the FMN, they can accept maximally two electrons and the two protons and completely reduce into the FADH2 or the FMNH2. After the complete reductions, these nucleotides, either the FAD or the NAD, and they are going to donate these electrons ultimately to the electron transport system and contribute for the ATP generation. Okay, so here up to this we discussed about the NAD and the FAD, its role in the electron transport system. Thank you.